Hey there, scientist. I've been working so hard this week. I've been observing, asking questions, and investigating the world around me so much that I've completed 5 investigations since our last lesson. Look, I have all my notes in here to prove it. I followed the scientific method and wrote down everything I learned inside my science notebook. Now that I'm finished with my investigations, I'm not exactly sure what I'm supposed to do with all of my notes. Why do scientists record their learning? Let's find out. We know that scientists observe, ask questions about, and investigate the natural world. But another huge part of science is recording your learning. When you record your learning, you are writing down information or drawing pictures of what you are investigating, just like the notes we took when we were investigating my plants. As we wrote and drew pictures about the 2 plants during our investigation, we were recording our learning. So why do scientists do this? There are many reasons scientists record their learning. The biggest reason is to communicate or share learning with others. When we share our knowledge with others, we can grow our knowledge even bigger. For example, last week, Mia did an investigation into how much water her plants need to stay healthy and strong. And we did an experiment and learned that one of my plants needed more direct sunlight to stay healthy and strong. When Mia and I share our scientific discoveries with each other, we gain even more knowledge about taking care of plants. Another reason scientists record their learning is to avoid doing the same investigation twice. As scientific questions get bigger and more complicated, they can require a lot of money, time, and scientists to investigate them. Some scientific investigations even go on for years. As scientists, it is important that we record our learning so everyone can learn from our investigations. Other scientists don't necessarily have to do their own investigation when they can learn from somebody else's. Aha! Learning. That brings me to another reason we record our learning as scientists, so we can teach others about our discoveries in the future. Let me give you an example. Electricity. Scientists have been investigating electricity for hundreds of years. It took many different investigations by many different scientists to learn all we know about electricity today. Electricity is part of our everyday lives because scientists of the past recorded their discoveries so that scientists of the future could learn from them. That means they were learning from each other without ever meeting each other. Pretty amazing. So, now we understand why we need to record our learning, but is there a certain way we're supposed to do it? The great thing about recording our learning is we can do it in so many ways. The most common ways to record scientific learning include using words, pictures, diagrams, and graphs. When we use words to record our learning, it is very important that we take our time to write neat and organized notes. If your notes are messy, other scientists won't be able to read your amazing discoveries. The same thing is true for our drawings. Remember, in science, we make ABCD drawings. That means our pictures are accurate, big, colorful, and detailed, like this. It is our job as scientists to make our pictures look as real as possible. There is a special kind of picture in science called a diagram. A diagram is an ABCD drawing with labels. Here is an example from Mia's investigation. In this diagram, she labeled parts of the plant she was investigating. You can see she used words and lines to point to the different parts of the plant. Diagrams are a great way to record your learning using pictures and words. Finally, we have graphs. A graph is a picture that organizes information. Anytime your investigation uses numbers, you can use a graph to share your learning. Let me tell you about one of the graphs I made during an investigation this week. I investigated the changing temperatures where I live. Summer is currently changing to fall, and I have noticed the afternoon temperatures seem to be cooling down. I decided to measure and record the temperature every day at noon for 1 week to test my hypothesis. You can see all of the temperatures I recorded here. Once I finished my investigation, I wanted to make a picture that would help make the information easier to see. So I made a graph. This graph is called a bar graph because of these bars you see here. In my graph, each bar represents the temperature for one day. The taller the bar, the higher the temperature was. The lower the bar, the lower the temperature was. Just looking at this graph, I can see that the temperature was getting a little bit cooler every day. So, why do scientists record their learning? As scientists, we record our learning so we can share it with others. When we share our discoveries with others, we avoid repeating complicated investigations and we build our knowledge together over time. As you continue to investigate the world around you, make sure you are recording and sharing your discoveries with others. And remember, science is all around you. Hey, hey.